I was invited to address the first Congress of the Council of African Organizations in London. They had a four-day Congress from the 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th, and had invited me there to make the closing address and bring the delegates from the various African organizations that are situated on the European continent up to date in regards to the struggle of the black man in this country in his quest for human rights and human dignity. And in conjunction with that invitation, I had gotten an invitation to visit Paris from the Afro-American community in Paris, which was sponsoring a rally in conjunction with the African community. And I was supposed to go there Tuesday also and address them and let them know the state of development or lack of development of our progress in this country for human rights or toward human rights. As many of you know, when I got to Paris, the man said I couldn't come in. Some man, French man. They gave me no explanation other than to say, we have our orders. They wouldn't let me phone the American embassy, and they tried to imply that the American embassy was behind it, which I told them that I didn't know de Gaulle had become a satellite of Lyndon B. Johnson. I knew that Kennedy had made a satellite out of Khrushchev and Britain and half of these other countries, but I didn't think that France was a satellite of the United States. Well, this made them angry because they like to be independent, you know, or pretend to be independent. The same thing happened in England. As many of you have probably read in the Sunday Times and Tribune, there was a great fear in England concerning me speaking to the West Indian community. And because England has a very serious color problem developing, because so many of our people are migrating there from the British West Indies. France, quietly as it is kept, has a very serious color problem developing because of the migration to France of our people from the French West Indies. And with these people from the French West Indies, black people going to France, others from the British West Indies going to England, coupled with the Asians who are coming from the Commonwealth territories, along with the Africans from French Equatorial West Africa, formerly into France and the British possessions into Britain. There's a large, increasing number of dark-skinned people swelling the dark population of France and Britain, and it's giving them a great deal of cause for worry. The only difference over there and over here being that no one of black skin in France has ever tried to unite the dark-skinned people together, neither have they done so in England. So you can somewhat see what their fear is. No effort has been made to unite the Afro-American community or the American Negro community with the West Indian community, and then those two communities with the African community, and those communities with the Asian community. This has never been done.